They're called Days of Rage protests. But what's ironic is that the protesters are peaceful, and it's the police who seem to be full of rage. In the past 10 days and counting, demonstrators have descended on Wall Street to protest the influence of U.S. financial institutions in American politics. Police have used mace and pepper spray and even fishnets to cage and confine the protesters. Here with his own personal story is protester Kelly Heresy and former 14-term New York State Assemblyman and Demos fellow Richard Brodsky. Gentlemen, welcome to Freedom Watch.
Thanks, Rob.
Kelly Heresy, what happened? What were you doing down there and what happened to you?
Okay, well, I was at the protests and the police came in with orange nets and they broke the protest up and penned a good portion of the demonstration to a wall and began making violent arrests.
And what did they do to you?
I was trying to take a picture to document one of the arrests, and I was close to a police officer. He saw me and he pepper sprayed me in the eyes.
Were you committing an act of violence?
Not at all.
Did you believe you were breaking the law?
I was simply taking a picture to document what was a very violent action by the police.
What are these protests about? I mean, one of them shows a young man carrying a sign that says, "Hungry? Eat a banker." What is that? There he is. What is that all about, Kelly Heresy?
Well, bankers are tasty, don't you know that?
I've never eaten one. Well, but what's the purpose of the protest? What's the message?
Well, the bankers have been feeding on the poor for many years, and they give out bad loans, they foreclose people's houses,
and they do all this in conjunction with big government.
Exactly.
All right, Mr. Brodsky. Whom I've known for many years. You're a former assemblyman here in the state of New York. But in the 60s, you yourself were tear gassed when demonstrating against the Vietnam War.
Well, it was a badge of honor then. It was down in Washington once and in Cambridge once. And those kinds of reactions by the police, we thought were past us. These guys are, to some extent, to the Boston Tea Party folks of today. And accommodating their ability to get that message out is something we ought to work much harder.
Well, that's the key word, Assemblyman Brodsky. Shouldn't the police be allowing them to demonstrate rather than preventing them from doing something? What do the police care about their message? Why would a cop pepper spray this young man because the cop doesn't like the message? Or is it just a power trip? I don't know
what each cop had in mind. Cops try to do good as they understand it. Sometimes they make terrible mistakes. The facts will come out in each individual case. What's at stake here is an argument that our liberty is being confined by large corporations as much as by large government. It's an unpopular message in many quarters. They have every right to get that message out. And as a libertarian judge, I would suggest that maybe you and I ought to expand the definition of a libertarian, not just someone concerned about government, but someone concerned about large corporations.
Well, when large corporations receive bailouts from the government, we don't really have a free market. We have corporatism. And you condemn corporatism. You condemn, Kelly Heresy, the notion that the people's hard-earned dollars would be given to wealthy banks to spend however they want rather than letting the people spend their own money. Am I right?
Absolutely. And I would just like to say that this incident that we're talking about right now is just one of many that's been ongoing for the whole 10 days that we've been down there.
Are they still down there?
Yes.
Are they still demonstrating as we speak?
We're still demonstrating and we're not leaving anytime soon.
And what will have to happen for the demonstrations to stop?
We'll have to see some results. And I just want to say that this police violence, it seems to be a systematic problem that's been occurring since at least the 60s.
Well, so, he's right about that. We only have about 30 seconds left. Why are the police violent? These kids aren't hurting anybody. They're not even blocking sidewalks.
Look, the individual cases of wrongdoing or rightdoing will be worked out by the system. In effect, this ought to be about their message and their ability to get it out through people like you and on the streets, like every American has a right to do.
You keep fighting for your right to be free, Kelly Heresy. And Richard Brodsky, it's a pleasure to have
Judge,
you.
Judge, nice to see you.
Thank you, guys.
We are the 99%.
The 99%. I don't know what that means, but we'll let you explain it next time.